Anyways, today we're out early so we can get 5 more questions answered, this time from a Tai Chi master. Chronicles, we are out here in San Bernardino, actually Fontana. Surveying Park is where we are, and we are going to meet Sifu Bill Rosary, who teaches Tai Chi to his students. Remember, if you haven't already, subscribe, hit the bell so you can be notified of any new videos coming out. All right, let's go check them out.
Welcome to Surveying Park. Surveying Park in Fontana, California. Welcome to our school. Tai Chi is where we are.
My condolences to the families that are affected by the pandemic virus. God bless you. Really important thing with all of this strife going on, remember to breathe.
So I'm out here with Sifu Bill Rosary, who teaches Tai Chi Chuan. I'm here in San Servine Park, Fontana. Beautiful day today. Sir, thanks for having me.
Thank you, sir.
And for all the audience, just give them a picture of how you kind of got started, training, and how you got up to this point, your motivation, training in Tai Chi.
I found my fighting style, Tai Chi.
Well, I started martial arts in Cape Cod, Massachusetts. I had a stepfather by the name of George Maddox, who was a Golden Gloves boxing champion, Hall of Famer, great man. He took the time to show me a little bit about boxing. And I was a terrible student. I was playing sports, I could care less about boxing, but he really wanted me to compete. So then, I have a young brother, Keith Rosary. He's the owner and practitioner and founder of the International Martial Arts Academy in Hyannis, Massachusetts, in Cape Cod. He's my hero. I watched him grow and I wanted to learn a little bit, so he took the time to try to teach me. Got me on the floor, tried to teach me the importance of stretching. I was a terrible student. But I got incurred an injury on Cape Cod to my back. And I had to have surgery, and I was told by doctors that I should plan on getting a whole lot of sport and to live in an area where it's arid as opposed to where I grew up in New England, and decided to move out here. In doing so, I came across my fraternity brother who was in a Lima Lama class.
Okay.
The instructor is Gilbert Garcia. I trained with him for a good 8 years.
Nice.
He recommended that I take some classes with the great Al Garza. Genius in martial arts.
Yes. Yes, sir.
What a blessing.
Yes, sir.
So I trained with him for a good 14 years.
Nice.
I really thank him for opening up my eyes. Time had passed, and with Gilbert Garcia, with kickboxing and all that, I kept injuring myself. And so I finally was referred to a doctor of traditional Chinese medicine, Dr. Z. Lo. And so when he said, hey, you know, you need Tai Chi. So on my way to work, like I do, every morning.
Okay.
So when I went past this park, I looked and I was out there in the park. So, oh man, I ran and hid behind a fence. And I just thought, oh man.
Like, what are they doing?
And this older gentleman was out there, he's just getting down.
Nice.
Beautiful. When they finished the set, one of the ladies, she came over to me and says, you like what you see? I said, yeah. She grabbed me by the hand and brought me over here.
Nice.
To this gentle giant. So I followed along, man, and we did about a half an hour, 45 minutes.
Oh, wow.
Set. When we got done, I had sweat pouring all down my brow. I needed a breath, I needed some water.
Yes, sir.
He looked at me, he laughed, and then he said something in Chinese and walked away, went home.
Wow.
I said, I'll be damned. So when the people interpreted for me, they said, hey, he said, he laughed at you, he said, you work too hard.
Okay.
So I said, okay. Suffice to say, 25 years later, I never missed class. I trained with him. So today, it's primarily because of the love that I have for my Sifu, Wei Yu Choi, the founder and president of the Southern California Tai Chi Chuan Association. That association he put together, he had over 40 schools under one roof. And it was his presence that everyone felt the need to leave their egos at the door when they come in. He put on some of the best and greatest Tai Chi events in Southern California history. For some reason, we had a relationship that he didn't have to understand a word that I said, and vice versa.
Do you understand the words that are coming out of my mouth?
Now time has gone by, and the phone rings. I get on the phone, someone speaks to me in English and says, Sifu wants to talk to you. Sifu told me I need you to come, I want you to come to a banquet. So I show up an hour early. He shows up with an entourage out of the van and he goes, we go in and I take my seat. So my Sifu sat right next to me.
Okay.
So he talked to me in Chinese. On his left side he had one son, on his right side he had another son. He asked me if I would be his successor. Would I be willing to take over? So I looked around and they're all looking at me like, what are you gonna do, folks?
This is a practical joke, right, bro?
What's my next move, man?
Sure. This is all I need to know. He got up, went over, then went to the head table, talked to people, we partied and everything. He got up and left. But on the way out, he said, I'm gonna give you about a month, month and a half. Invite whoever you want. So I invited everybody at the park, all the masters, Ken Edwards, Al Garza, Troy Osborne, Steve Reed, Carl Totten, Wilson Kwan, Tommy Chan.
Everyone!
The greats.
Gotcha.
They were there, we were waiting, and my sequel came with another entourage and brought out the banner. And sat down and he gave me a piece of paper. So I'm expecting him to make the announcement. He went like this.
Only 5,000.
He said, nah, you're it now. Like, you know, you're it.
It's
your non. So I had to go. And I've been going ever since.
You do have a little bit of history. Way back when I started, your son BJ was doing Kung Fu at Chantung. And man, he was amazing. We'd all look at BJ and BJ's doing the flips and all that. So we got a special history, you and I. The segment's basically called Five Crucial Questions for Kung Fu Masters. In this case, it would be a Tai Chi master like yourself. Can I ask you those questions, sir?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's do it.
One, two, three, four, five.
Well, Tai Chi is called the Grand Ultimate Fist. It means Supreme Fist. The Grand Ultimate goal, from what I've learned over the years, there's a lot that's written about Tai Chi, there's a lot that's said, but what I've got out of it, my interpretation is that the goal is to empty your mind of all thoughts, to be stress-free, to let go, relax. You'll hear that constantly in Tai Chi, relax. This is the first time that, since my Sifu has passed, that I have really spoken and gave my opinion. So I really want to thank God for the opportunity to be here today and talk to you. But without him, none of this means anything. So Tai Chi builds character internally. The breathing helps to nourish the major organs in your body. The exercises help to loosen the joints. The concept of everything being a circle, you get to deal with the yin and yang in any and all situations, the elements. Those who would like to learn Tai Chi from me specifically, my telephone number is area code 626-298-5136. I'm not here to sell Tai Chi. I'm here to promote Tai Chi. Well, my motivation to pass it on is real simple. My Sifu, he didn't charge me a penny.
0.0.
And he came to me one day, he says, you gotta charge money. You gotta, as a Sifu, you didn't charge me any money. Well, you're different. You're different. He says, I just want you to promote Tai Chi. And he says, part of the reason why he chose me was because I instinctively promoted Tai Chi. I enjoy teaching. I enjoy the movement. When you lose your health and you get your health back, you cherish the opportunity to move. So therefore, my goal has always been to grow old gracefully. No one has to ask me or encourage me to do Tai Chi or to teach it. So, I try not to talk about Tai Chi. It's like the Bible. I get so upset when people, they try to, what they learn in the Bible, they misquote the Bible.
Well, there's this passage I got memorized. Ezekiel 25:17.
I'm not gonna do that. So the same thing regarding Tai Chi. There's a lot of books, materials, and things that are written. I'll let everybody do the talking. Yeah. That's not how I got it. Started off simply because my Sifu gave me the freedom. But I love music. I was really heavy into basketball. I would train and listen to music, and it kind of calms me down. And same, I would listen to music as often as I could. So I would come to class, I always had headphones on because I couldn't understand what my Sifu was talking about. So I wanted to entertain my own self. And my Sifu, he was curious one day. Yes, he said, why are you listening to music?
Yeah.
And I loved it, Sifu, you know.
Yeah.
And he says, one day he surprised me. He says, we all want to hear your music. Put it on. It's music. And he actually did Tai Chi with me one day.
Right.
Listen to music. And he got a kick out of it. Right. And so he encouraged me, here, be yourself, do your thing.
Right.
So ever since then, I always got away from the traditional Chinese music, because I don't know, it just doesn't, there's some of it that's good, but I like my soul music, I like my R&B, my jazz.
I'm gonna make it do what it do, baby.
I would always, and I still do today, train on my own. When I'm not teaching, I can really get into the music, get into myself. But when I'm teaching, I want my students to enjoy So I encourage them, you want to play music? Nah, I like your music, Sifu. All
right,
we'll play it.
Gotcha.
To answer that particular question, I'm going to have to look off into the... I have to gaze off. And I have to gather myself and show respect.
So,
and not laugh. So. And not... But then I'd be phony.
And I'm not that.
To me, that was not a good exhibition of self-defense fighting. But it's like anything else in life. I don't care at what level. You're always going to have people that, you know, won't do it or demonstrate it or express it as good. But I'm a firm believer that you look at that film and you look at where martial arts is today, you have a barometer. And you get a chance to really see how far we've come without speaking negatively about it. All I can tell people who have not seen it, you cannot disguise movement. It speaks for itself. My parents always taught me, if you can't say something good about something, try not to say anything about it.
Yeah,
so I'm going to gaze off. I'm proud to be a black man. I'm proud to be an American. I'm even more proud of the ability of people to come together and have fellowship.
Sir.
And I think that's what martial arts has been for me. I started late, and I started for different reasons. I didn't need to learn how to fight. All I wanted to do was move again. And so, as a black man, as an American, I appreciate having the health, through the grace of God, to be able to pick and choose what's useful to me and what's helpful to me. And the only thing I can do is do what my sequel told me. He said, all you need is one student. I don't judge anybody based upon the numbers of students they have or how pretty their uniforms are. And I judge people on their how they move and how they conduct themselves and how they carry their art. I was fortunate to be around some great people, so I don't really have a whole lot of negative things to say about that. Because anywhere I've been, anything I've ever done, anytime I've ever asked, this hasn't been an issue or a problem. I haven't really run into anything like that. So I'm really grateful for the opportunity to be here and express myself, because I'm one thing I did learn, talk is cheap. Just practice.
All right, so there you have it. Another 5 questions answered with another Kung Fu master, this time a Tai Chi master. Drop your comments down below. Let me know the questions you'd like to be asked. We'll hopefully get to answer a lot more of them. All right, subscribe if you haven't already. And thanks to Sifu Bill Rosary for being a part of this video.
This is Sifu Bill Rosary. Thank you for watching Kung Fu Chronicles.
See you guys in the next round, and keep punching.